This is Corin.
This is Craig. Thank you all for coming. Craig's going to introduce a little bit. I'll talk a little bit, and then we'll have some great entertainment, I'm sure.
Well, I think first, Bill is in the house.
And I'd like now, at this point, to call upon my father, William McFadden, to deliver an opening prayer for tonight.
Well, it's amazing. We recently did this ad for the PEI Seafood. It's called We're Not Humble. And I said, this is really humbling. I thank you all for coming out. This is a little prayer I say every day in the morning. I was taught this by the Shambhala elders when I went off to work in Toronto. I'll have to change one word. Okay. In the quiet of this morning hour, I come to thee for peace, wisdom, and power. To view the world through love-filled eyes. Be patient, understanding, gentle, wise. To see beyond what seems to be, and know thy children as thou knowest them. So naught but good in anyone behold. Make deaf my ears to slander that is told. Silence my tongue to aught that is unkind. Let only thoughts that bless dwell in my mind. Let me so kindly be, so full of cheer, that all I meet may sense thy presence near. Clothe me in beauty, this I pray, that I may reveal thee, Lord, through all this day. That's how I usually start my day before I get up and go about, and then I usually say, you know, Dad, I haven't done anything wrong yet. I haven't lied and cheated or stolen, but I'm about to get out of bed, so hope you go with me through the day. Now, when Craig approached me, I said, yo, this sounds like a great idea. It's something right out of Tuesdays with Maury, and I always like that story. But this is for everybody. Everybody has, we're all having our own little struggles in life. And it's, you know, if we do like that opening prayer and we try to be there for one another, it makes the world around a lot smoother. So I'm going to get a chance to introduce the first act, I guess. And that's David Rashid and Anne-Marie Voila. I'm sorry. See, this is what happened. They threw me the room. Actually, it's my very good friend, John Reeder, and actually I had invited him, so I'm going to turn it back over to Corin before I make a total mess of this.
No,
thanks for your strange lift.
Chinatown, it's Saturday night. Ladies and gentlemen, John Reeder, our good friend.
The brokenness breathes to me now. The fragrance of those promises you never dared to vow. The splinters that you carried, the cross you left behind. Come healing of the body, come healing of the mind. Let the spirits hear the penitential hymn. Come healing of the spirit, come healing of the limb.
And on that day, the Lord will come to meet his bride. And when we see him, in an instant,
about my father and what he means to me. So I began to think about this last night, and I thought, and there's so many stories that I could tell. But I'm going to tell a little story about a play we did at the Jubilee in Summerside called You Can't Take It With You. And in this play, I played a few other cast members were here. I think my brother Will is here. And I want to say a big shout out first, before I tell my story, to everybody who's come here and joined us on this incredible journey that began so long ago, and it's kind of culminating here with so much love. I've seen so many friendly faces around, and I don't have time to say hi to everyone. Thank you. So in this play, I played, I think, a 87-year-old man who had this crazy extended family. Nothing like my own, of course. And at one point, when we were rehearsing, and I'm thinking, why aren't I playing this part? Or why aren't I playing that part? And he calls me aside. He said, you could play any of these parts. I said, I know. Why aren't I? He said, because this one you're going to learn something from. And it's going to be hard for you, but it'll be one of the best things you've ever done. And he was right. And it was a really story about like loving those people that are with you while they're here and really experiencing all the crazy various ways that people know and love each other. So that was the story, and he's taught me so many lessons in my life. If I were to start to tell you all the lessons that I've learned from my father, we'd be here well past our time of 8 o'clock. So
just a moment, and
just think about the stories that you know about my dad and what he's meant to you in your life and what's brought you out here today to celebrate his really wonderful, long, accomplished life that's so many wonderful memories and so many imprints on so many people's hearts. There's one other thing that I wanted to say about my dad, that it's doing the things that are right when no one's watching is what's really most important. And I had the opportunity to share some very nice is not even the right word, but some real devotion and service, sharing with my dad some prayer in the little chapel here before, where he was doing the evensong religiously, apparently, for like a year straight or something. So I really want to thank him for helping me to find the quiet spots where God speaks to us. It was he and I and the minister, maybe one or two other people on a couple of occasions, and it's really the service that's to self is the service to God. And my dad has really helped me learn about God and hopefully teach about God as we grow up together.
My life, I've loved them all, but of all these friends and lovers, there is no for people and things that were before. I know I'll often stop and think about them.
And she said, I think Bill would really like something with like a little wink in it, you know, something a little coy, and that seemed right. So this is sort of my version of another Tom Waits song. This is I Don't Want to Grow Up.
When I'm lying in my bed at night, I don't want to grow up. Nothing ever seems to turn out right. I don't want to grow up. How do you move in a world of fog where it's always changing things? Makes me wish that I could be the dog. When I see the price you pay, grow up. I'm gonna ride my bike all day. I don't wanna grow up. Seems like folks turn into things they never wanna be. The only thing to live for is today. I'm gonna dance down Richmond Street. I don't wanna grow up. Feel the earth beneath my feet. I don't wanna grow up. I don't wanna be filled with doubt. I don't wanna be a good boy scout. Say my piece, maybe run for mayor. Head out west, well, I don't wear. I don't wanna grow up. I'm gonna wear a tri-cornered hat. I don't wanna grow up. Claim my bill, well, how about that? I don't wanna grow up. I'm gonna wear a long white robe. Start a script and build a show. Weave a tale and help my friends float along the river bend. I'm gonna laugh all afternoon. A boy on a big balloon. No, I don't wanna grow up. No, I don't wanna grow up.
Well, then, none of us knows when we're gonna die. Not him. Not me, not you. So obviously we have to live every second as if it was our last. And my teacher in all of that has been Bill, or Izzard Goat, as he's known to some of us. But it's not always comfortable. Sometimes it's a, Izzard, please, can we just calmly drink our coffee? Do we have to lift that homeless man up off the street? Yes, we have to lift him up off the street. Because he's one of God's creatures, he's in pain, and we're not going to stand here calmly drinking our coffee while he's suffering. Okay, Izzard? Okay? But do we have to go outside? It's so cold. Yes, we have to go outside. Because look at the sky, it's China blue. And look at that deep, dark green of those spruce trees spread out against that ermine white meadow. Now, do you want to experience that as if inside a prophylactic? Or do you want to burst out into it? Okay, Izzard. Okay. All right. Okay.
What would he know about condoms?
You make balloon out of them.
And you know, sometimes it's, we're going to go up to that young woman and that old man at that bus stop, and we're going to talk to them. Why? Do you know them, Izzard? No, I don't know them. But we're going to invite them to join us in the lobby of the Charlottetown Hotel tonight and put on a Chekhov play. Izzard, are you crazy? They're going to say no. So what if they say no? We're extending a hand to another human being. Maybe they'll say yes. And even if they do say no, at least we've taken a risk and we experience the thrill of risk. And even the sting of rejection is life. It puts blush in your cheek. Okay, Izzard. All right. But nobody does he hold to a higher standard than himself. When it's, I'm sick. I'm really sick. And all I want to do is get away from people and just lie here in the dark. No, you're not going to lie in the dark. We're going to turn on the lights, and we're going to get up on a big stage in a church, and we're going to shout at the top of our lungs, life is beautiful.
Yeah.
Hey.
And we're giving... And in that way, we're giving a gift to the people who love us and who we love. And we're showing them that when things are really dark and you think it's the end, this is the way to do it. So he's giving us a gift of bravery. Okay, Izzard. Okay. And so the experience of a 50-year friendship with this man is like the experience of standing there and watching a comet streak across the sky.
Anymore. I mentioned it. It turned out it's his co-worker where he works at the Whisperwood Villa. He said, everybody at the Whisperwood Villa loves this young man.
And if I could, I surely would stand on the rock where Moses stood. Army got drowned. Mary, don't you weep. And Mary wore three links of chain. On every link was Jesus' name. Pharaoh's army got drowned. Mary, don't you weep.
National anthem, which I loved as a child, but I haven't heard since. Is that all right? I got to confer with Bill on how he wanted this song to show, or, you know, I guess what I'm going to call it. You know, at first it was called The King of Poor Enough Island, which is what he calls this place, Poor Enough Island. But then I thought, well, maybe the prophet. And then I said, well, I'll just ask him. And he said, the emperor. So I'll try that. The emperor.
Stay.
has to lead with Stan the Storm. He looked and said, I am the storm. I remember once when I this is one of my first memories of my dad when I was not, my probably around the same age as Ivan there. And my dad was doing a show at the Confederation Center and he was playing a tree or something and facing the tree. And there's a part comes in the show where the woodman's come. Well, some of you could probably remember this, but the woodman comes to chop down a tree and I come running to the front of it and said, don't you come chop down my daddy. Everybody, feel free to cry if you want.
It's funny, during the CBC interview, afterwards, Bill said, did I show too much of my heart? I said, no, just the right amount.
I love him.
Frank has a very special gift here that he'd like to present to my dad here tonight. You want to tell a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. So, if anyone has seen a Sifu video called Not Humble, it starts with
PEI, Prince Edward Island.
Of course, that's his voice. And we took some pictures of the day we filmed, and his great friend Kat, who asked me not to point her out, but I did. And she just finished this painting today.
No, it's not finished. No.
It's almost finished.
It's not finished.
She worked really hard this week and pulled a lot of hours to get it to where it is. Three to four years is that his faith is real to him. And John, you couldn't say it better. I love that it's real to Bill.
What a day of rejoicing that will be.
We will see your glory revealed.
be the end of tonight's festivities here. We have to move elsewhere. But thank you all very much for coming. I'd like to say a special thanks to everyone who got up here tonight. I'd like to thank David Rashid and Anne-Marie Valois. I'd like to thank Eden McFadden, Fraser McCollum, John Giler, Joseph McMillan, Al Tuck, Craig Harris, of course, John Reeder, and all of our very special guests and friends and loved ones tonight. May you all travel safe. May God go with you. Bless you all, and thank you for coming. And this is my father, William McFadden.
I'll close on a secular poem. It's a poem I learned in grade 3, and it sums up pretty much how I view the life. And it's by William Wordsworth. It goes, "My heart leaps up when I behold a rainbow in the sky. So was it when my life began. So is it now I am a man. So be it when I shall grow old or let me die. The child is father of the man. And I could wish my days to be blessed each to each in natural piety. Thank you and good night. Drive home safely."
Your eyes.